Hello, in this final video of Laboratory 1 video tutorials, we're going to look at one of the most powerful features of the ArcMap program, and that is how we export, create and export maps for use in research or for use in publications and what have you. We're going to continue using the same data set which we've been using before. We have our Ireland Towns data set, we have our Clare Towns which we created as part of the this spatial data query tutorial, and we have our Irish counties and our Ireland coastline. The first thing I'm going to do is just show you the two primary layouts in ArcMap. The first one, which we have here, is called the data view. As you can see down here, there's a shortcut key which will always bring you back to this view. The second view, and what we're going to be looking at today, is called the layout view. And the layout view, if we can click that, is the view we go into when we want to export a map, when we want to make a map and export it as a graphics file. These two views can also be accessed by going to Views in the top up here and clicking between Data View and Layout View. Okay. Now, while it's in Layout View, we can pretty much perform any queries or any changes to the data which we want to perform. When working within this view, this pointer key becomes a lot more useful, because with this pointer key we can do things like expand the size of our map viewing window, like such, so that it takes up more space. Also useful in these are these two zoom fixed, fixed zoom and fixed zoom in, fixed zoom out. To give you an example why, if we want to play around with what might be the best size for use in a map, this is a particularly useful tool. Okay, so what we're going to do in this session is we are going to output a map of County Clare showing all the towns in County Clare. We want to do this by repeating some of the processes we've done already. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off Ireland Towns and I'm going to turn on Clare Towns. Now, you can see from the shape of Clare data that actually making a map in this kind of portrait shape page isn't actually the best way to do it. So what we're going to do is we're going to change this from portrait into a landscape format. And that means that instead of looking at the page vertical, we're going to be looking at it horizontal. To do this, we go up to File, Page and Print Setup. And within this, we have the option of selecting landscape. Okay, now we can either use the zoom in and zoom out keys at this point just to better fix this, or we can use the scroll bar in the middle of your mouse. This might actually be a lot easier to use at this time, so if we just move out a little bit here. And we've got to make sure this map fits to this page, so what we're going to do is we are going to drag this down and across. And we can see that Ireland is placed in the centre of the landscape map. Now the next step we want to do is actually we want to zoom in just to the relevant area, which is going to be Clare. And when it's in there, we can use the pan tool just to straighten it up a little bit. Okay. Now, it's definitely worth, in a case like this, messing around, playing around with the symbology a little bit, just to give it a more aesthetic feel. So let's go back into our Ireland counties and let's change the counties back into all different colours like we did in the previous tutorial. Properties, symbology, categories, make sure this is a unique values, and then we're going to pick our value field name and we're going to add all values. We're going to continue using this pastel colour chart here. Apply and OK. Excellent. So we can now see that each one of our Irish counties has a different colour, and the County Clare is in the centre in this kind of lime green olive colour. Now we might choose at this point that we want to zoom in just a little bit further just to maximise the use of space. Let's use the pan just to bring that over a bit. Okay, great. So now we've centred the area we want. We can see each of these little dots which represent Clare Towns. We can change the colour if we want to of that. Let's do that. Again, into symbology. We're going to stay with the fixed symbol, which just gives the one colour for everything. And let's lots of little squares. Let's change the color to a dark gray, and the size, let's bring that right down to say 4. Okay. Play around with these if you want by yourself. It's very difficult to do any proper damage. Get familiar with it. And we can see now that each of the towns, if we were to zoom right in, are tiny little squares. Okay, we saw in one of the previous sections how we label data. Well, let's do that here as well. Let's label let's label each of these towns. Again, right click, properties, labels, label features in this layer, and we want to name it according to the town name, which in this shapefile is under the town 2 attribute. And click apply. Okay, if you're stuck in this section here, you can also change the properties of this label. You can change the font, and you can also change the size or whether or not you want it in bold or in italics. So let's select italics and click OK. Now we can see that we've named each of the towns in County Clare. Now, what we're going to do now is we're going to incorporate some of the features which are most important when making a map. Now, we touched on some of these in our seminars and in our lectures, but there's a couple of things a map must always have. It must always have a north arrow so that it can be oriented. It must always have a scale bar so that we have some kind of concept as to what scale we're dealing with. It can also be useful, depending on how complicated a map is, to include a legend. We input all these things by going up to the Insert button up here, dropping down on that, and we're given all these options here. It can also be good to put a title in a map so that people know exactly what they're looking at the moment they do. So let's start off with the North Arrow. Select North Arrow. And this will load up a whole load of different styles of North Arrow to use. I'd always say it's good to keep these things quite simple. The main focus is on the map, not on the North Arrow. So let's just pick this kind of quite standard black arrow. And what this will do is it will add it. Now, as long as you're on the pointer over here, you can pick up that, you can drag it to wherever you want. Top left-hand corner is nice. You can make that much larger or much smaller. So let's go for a little bit smaller. And we can see that we've now successfully placed a North Arrow in the GIS. Now, the GIS organizes things according to geographical space. We can see our coordinate system down here when we're on the map. So the North Arrow will always generally be facing in the same direction because the data will always be stored and will always be displayed according to a northerly orientation. We can, of course, change this. We're not going to go into this in this episode. But if you see your North Arrow going off to one side, that is because that is the way the data has been displayed. And it's an accurate representation of the orientation of the GIS. The next thing which we're going to add is a scale bar. Again, we want to go to Insert. We want to click Scale Bar. And again, we're given the option of several different styles of scale bar. Now, we're actually just going to stick with the default scale bar, the one which is just the automatic one. So we're not going to select anything. We're actually just going to click OK. But you can see there that you can select a large number of different scale bars. And this will automatically add a scale bar to the map. See here. So we're going to drag that down just so we can look at it a bit closer. Now, something going on here which is worth just observing. The scale bar is presented in meters. However, realistically, on a county scale, we're dealing with a scale where meters are not the ideal unit to be using. They're just too large. 16,000 meters on this scale really means very little. So we need to change that to kilometers. We do that by making sure that the scale bar is highlighted, right-clicking on it, and going into its properties. And then under here, we're given the option of units. We can change this from meters to kilometers. You can also change things in here, like the number of units you want to have. And these are the breaks in the scale bar down here. But we're going to leave it as it is and just select kilometers. Click Apply. And OK. Excellent. And we can see that having done that, what's actually happened is the scale bar has shrunk slightly to fit to 10 kilometers, which is a much more usable and a much easier scale. So we're going to leave it at that. We're going to drag that into the corner. However, if we wanted to change it, if we were to drag this out, we'd see that the scale alters considerably and drops up to 20 kilometers. This is because in a GIS, displays things according to their actual spatial locations, so it's relatively constant. If we were to zoom in and out of this map, similarly the scale bar would change. Now, the final thing we're going to add to this, although we could add a number of things, is a legend. So again, we're going to go to Insert, we're going to click on Legend, and we're given the option of all the things which we want to include in the legend, in this legend items things here. A legend tells the viewer of the map exactly what the different symbols they're looking at mean. So we only actually want to include a single thing in here. We just want to have the town, so people know that when they're looking at a little rectangular block on the map, that they're actually looking at a town. So we're going to highlight the ones we don't want, and we're going to move them just by clicking back across. And we're going to leave it just at Clare Towns. And we're going to go Next. That's the title of our legend, and we're just going to leave it as Legend. Don't worry about any of these, we'll leave the default going and we'll just finish it. Building Legend. And there we are. So let's move that down there to include it just above kilometres. We can see that we have our North Arrow, we have our Scale Bar, and we have our Legend, which is Clare Towns. Very simple output of a map. Perhaps not the prettiest map we've ever seen, but it incorporates all the major factors which are necessary when building a map. So the final thing we're going to look at is how to export this map into some way which we can use it properly. So we do this by going up to File, we're going to go to Export Map, just taking some time. And we're given this export map option. So we can pick things like what resolution do we want to export it at. 300 dpi is quite high, let's lower it down to 200. And then you choose where exactly you want to save it to. So I'm going to save it into the same place where I have actually saved my Lab 1 data, and I'm going to call it Clare Towns. And what this will do is it will automatically save it as a EMF, but we're going to actually change that to change saving it to a JPEG. A JPEG is a kind of standard graphics file, I'm sure plenty of you will be familiar with it. Let's up that resolution, let's change it down again there, and then just click Save. Down here then you can see it's telling you what it's doing, it's exporting this map. And once that has exported, we can then leave the GIS, we can go back into the folder where we saved it, and we can look at it. Just in a normal program, we don't need the GIS anymore. And there's our map. So if we wanted to insert that into a project we were doing on towns in County Clare, and that is what we do. Okay, that's the end of this tutorial.